JBN, we keep you informed. I am Michelle Jones, and in the news, man and woman arrested after gun find. A man and a woman have been arrested in relation to the seizure of a 9mm Beretta pistol with a magazine containing 10 9mm rounds of ammunition during an operation on Payne Avenue, Kingston 11. Reports from the Hunsby Police are that lawmen found the firearm during a search of a premises and its occupants about 3:30 p.m. on Friday. The two were subsequently taken into custody. Their identities are being withheld pending further investigations. Two suspects nabbed after house set ablaze, occupants shot at in Bull Bay. Two men have been charged in relation to their alleged involvement in a shooting incident and a burning of a house in 9 miles Bull Bay, St. Andrew in October. Accused are 25-year-old Fadid Johnson, customer service representative, and 28-year-old Damien Anderson, both of 9 Miles, Bull Bay. Reports are that about 6 p.m. on Thursday, October 29, the complainant was at home when several men, including the two accused, set the house ablaze and fired several shots at the occupants who managed to escape. Johnson and Anderson were subsequently apprehended and charged with shooting with intent, illegal possession of firearm, and illegal possession of ammunition. Their court date is being finalized. 22 persons detained at illegal party, woman and a senior citizen charged. 22 persons were detained by law enforcers during a series of operations in the St. Andrew South Police Division. The police said the operation also resulted in a woman being charged with the breaches of the Spirit License Act and a man for breaching the Noise Abatement Act. The operations were conducted on Thursday, December 19. The accused are 58-year-old Christine Stone of Bay Farm Road, St. Andrew, and a 70-year-old Kenneth Campbell of Lissant Road, Kingston. Reports are that an illegal party was in session at McDonald's Place off Olympic Way in St. Andrew. A joint operation was carried out between the hours of 3 p.m. and 7 p.m. by police personnel from the Specialized Operations Branch, the Counterterrorism and Organized Crime Investigation Branch, CTOC, and the Jamaica Defense Force, JDF, which resulted in 22 persons being detained and warned for prosecution. Two pieces of sound system equipment, as well as 57 bottles of assorted spirits, were seized. The police continue to urge Jamaicans to report illegal parties that are scheduled to take place during the festive season in an effort to prevent the spread of the coronavirus, COVID-19. The Jamaica Constabulary Force, JCF, in a release, has asked persons who are aware of any illegal parties or unapproved events being held to tag them on social media with direct messages or WhatsApp the information to 876-591-5671. Man charged with murder of Mona Commons' sisters. A 22-year-old man has been charged with the September killings of two sisters in Mona Commons, St. Andrew. The police say O'Shane Plummer, otherwise called Steady, of Tavern Drive, Kingston 6, has been charged with two counts of murder and illegal possession of a firearm. His court date is being finalized. On September 17, Renee Martel, 23, and Shauna K. Hunter, 31, were shot in their yard by gunmen. The police report that about 2:15 p.m., Plummer and the three armed suspects traveling on motorcycles in Mona Commons approached and shot Hunter and Martel. The victims were taken to hospital where they were pronounced dead. Investigations led to Plummer's arrest and he was charged on Thursday, December 10. Meanwhile, the police are asking anyone with information on the whereabouts of the other suspects involved in the incident to contact the Major Investigation Division at 876-758-5048, Crime Stop at 311, or the nearest police station. However, the police did not name the suspects. Convicted Manchester robber and female accomplices sentenced to prison. A man and two women, who were all convicted for their roles in the use of an illegal taxi to stage a 7-month robbery spree in Manchester, were on Friday handed prison sentences. They are David Taylor, Lucien Chambers and Melissa Martin. Taylor had been convicted in the Manchester Circuit Court earlier this year on 8 counts of robbery with aggravation, while Chambers pleaded guilty to 4 counts of the same offense. Chief Justice Brian Sykes, who presided over the case, ordered that Taylor serve 6 years in prison at hard labor for each of the first 7 offenses and 9 years for the remaining charge. Chambers was sentenced to 5 years in prison at hard labor for each count. Their sentences are to be served concurrently. Martin, who accompanied the two on only one of the robberies, was sentenced to 3 years in prison at hard labor. The evidence heard by the court was that starting in December 2017, Taylor used an illegal taxi with Chambers posing as a passenger to rob at least 8 women of $159,000 and US$530, as well as 9 mobile phones and a tablet. In the first incident, on December 14, 2017, a woman alleged that an illegal taxi pulled up beside her as she walked to the New Green Roundabout in Manchester. The woman told investigators that Taylor, who was the driver, told her to get into the vehicle and she complied, believing she was being offered a ride. However, she said Taylor, along with Chambers, who was in the front passenger seat, drove to a dead-end road, pulled a ratchet knife and took her phone and gold chain necklace before allowing her to leave the vehicle. The pair struck again on February 2, 2018, robbing 2 women of a total of $10,000 and 3 mobile phones in Abbey Gardens. A third robbery took place on the morning of May 9, 2018. The victim was robbed of $137,000 and US$500. She was picked up at a gas station, the court heard, where she had gone to get a cab to go to work after leaving her car at a repair shop. The woman told investigators that Taylor, with Chambers aboard in the front passenger seat, drove a short distance from the main road, telling her that he had to pick up someone. She said he stopped the vehicle and rolled up all the windows and inquired if she had a gun. After questioning her, he eventually drove to a nearby house where he pulled a knife and robbed her of $137,000 Jamaican dollars and US$500. Negril's small businesses taking a curfew beating. Some business operators in Westmoreland are not pleased with a recent decision by Prime Minister Andrew Holness to alter the COVID-19 curfew hours in the parish and are publicly voicing their disagreement. The disgruntled business operators said that the new time period of 7 p.m. to 5 a.m. is outrageous, and they want the Prime Minister to consider the millions of dollars they'll be losing over the next 2 weeks. Popular business operator Devon James, the owner and operator of Best in the West Jerk Spot, located on Norman Manley Boulevard, said the new curfew time has affected his business significantly. "This has affected my business significantly because dinner time is the main time when tourists come to a place like mine, and dinner time anywhere in Negril is 7 o'clock. So all the tourists will not be staying within the all-inclusive hotels and won't be coming out to dinner," James said. "We have been closed since March 20, shortly after the COVID-19 broke out in Jamaica, and we reopened only a week ago and was trying to blend with the 10 o'clock cutoff time. But this new time situation is madness. The 10 o'clock was good for me because we could do the dinner time, but this new time has dealt my business and all small businesses in Negril a serious blow," he added. James, whose business usually operates with 2 shifts, but can't now because of the cut in his earning power, said businesses like his are at a disadvantage because while he has no choice but to operate within the curfew limitations, the all-inclusive resorts are allowed to operate at all hours to include staging parties. "The government needs to find a way to deal with the spike in COVID-19, like for instance, hand out masks to everyone and have persons walking the street to enforce the COVID-19 protocols. But to just get up and close down an entire business community after they have already suffered for over 9 months is a very stupid move," James said. Matthew Wallace, who operates Matthew's Restaurant and Bar in the resort town, said the new restrictions will have a negative impact on his business, but he's nonetheless thankful that some of his guests are adapting to the new time. "6 o'clock is normally my dinner time. That is the time when my guests start coming. but the new time of 7 p.m. is unorthodox. I guess now is the time to adjust and adapt where you can, because we're all facing it. I myself have had to cut down to one shift. Businessman Richard Wallace, president of the Negril Chamber of Commerce, who also operates the Boardwalk Resort, said that many small business operators have been expressing unhappiness with the new curfew hours. It is going to hurt business, especially the small restaurants, retail outlets, and supermarkets, said Wallace. It is the business operators who depend on the movable traffic, especially within the township, who will feel the effects. So yes, it's a very hard blow with Christmas just 10 days away. Now is the time when a lot of us were hoping to make up for the losses that we would have been encountering over the last 9 months. And there are a lot of businesses that are hurting. And you know, this is unfortunate that we are at this position right now, added Wallace. On Wednesday, the Ministry of Health and Wellness reported that the parish of Westmoreland had recorded 18 new positive cases of COVID-19, pushing the number of cases in the parish up to 520. 87-year-old man dies from COVID as Jamaica registers 86 new infections. An 87-year-old man from Trelawney has died from COVID-19, bringing the country's death toll to 286. His death came as 86 new infections were registered on Saturday, according to the Ministry of Health and Wellness. Based on the latest data, Jamaica has recorded 12,224 since the first case was reported here in March. The health minister reported that 18 of the new infections were in St. James, 15 in St. Anne, 11 in Manchester, while Westmoreland, Clarendon, and Kingston and St. Andrew had 10 each. The remaining cases were in Trelawney 4, St. Catherine 4, St. Mary 3, Hanover 3, and Portland 1. Active cases for Saturday were 2,816 after 154 recoveries were reported. JBN, we keep you informed. Please remember to subscribe, like, share, leave us a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our daily news items.